Hello, everyone. Welcome to part 13 of my SimCity 4 city construction project. This time around, I'm going to work on filling in this corner here. I think maybe I'll put in a landmark somewhere in the tile as well. It gives me something of a, an obstacle to work around, I guess. And after all, there's no money problem here, so I'm going to do that right now. Go put the landmark over here. So that means getting into the landmarks. Now let's go for something relatively large. Oh, that's a option for a large landmark. Right, okay. That's what we'll use. The Great Pyramid. You know what? Right about here seems appropriate. Okay. I wonder, can you build more than one? Dude, you can. Let's have three of them. That gives us a good excuse for why the rail line goes where it is, and also gives a reasonable explanation for this little village over here. If you recall, this was a completely separate village when I started, before this development moved across here. I'm not worried about power to the pyramids here. That will be sorted out later. Now, over here, what I need to do is, let's see, around here, I think I'm going to go for a medium density right along here, and then I'll drop back to a low density situation here. So I need some roads here, and this will do nicely, and it lines up nicely too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, not so much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We'll put that here. 7, 8. Yeah, okay, that'll work. Now, over here, I have a little bit of a problem, and how I'm going to fill this in. I think this area will be sort of a park area. And then, yeah, I think I'll do it that way. Okay. But first, I need a road to come down this way. No, that doesn't work. But an actual intersection does. Yeah, I don't want that sharp. Actually, maybe I do. No. No. There we go. Yeah, it just looks wrong. Yeah, so I'm not gonna do that. No, I'm gonna go for the sharp corner there. It actually looks better. And this really needs to be four-way. Okay. So I can go out to here. And then I can come up here. Yes, that'll work. And this can come across this way, and I can have, okay, good. 5, 6, 7, there we go. Ooh, that's interesting. Oh well. Okay. That works. Yes, good. Yes, okay, good. I think I like that. Yeah, I can't do that. Okay, good. Now, time to put some plumbing in. Okay. Okay. Right. I think I need to replace my pumps. No, they're good. No, they're still good. Okay. Okay, so far so good there. Good. Now, what's the demand for here? Oh, okay, we're good. Put some residential in here. There we go. And also in here. Right. And here. And I'll put some commercial there. And here. Now, let's see. I'll plant some grass here. Okay. And good. Okay, so this scheme here works well as long as it doesn't decide to split this lot. If it splits it, then this internal bit has no road access. Okay, so now we have to wait a little bit for development to occur. Meanwhile, I'm going to fill in my forest here. And just like on the other side, I need to make this grass so the trees aren't growing through the bridge. So, easily done. This area here, I think, will be a plaza. Maybe a pedestrian mall, actually. Yeah, that might be better. So those are in here, I believe. I've probably gone past them. Nope. That's not it. No. Wait a minute. Maybe it's in here. No. Okay. No, maybe I won't do that. Now I'll go with Plaza in here. Okay, so these plazas should actually help with commercial demand as well, which, there we go. You can see as soon as I was building those, the commercial stuff here started filling in. And it didn't split this lot, so everything should be good. Okay, so I'm going to need to leave a buffer with between the rail here. So I'll just build that. And like so. This isn't really ideal, but we have to have some less desirable places to live somewhere. Okay, I need something coming into here. Yeah, I think that'll be good. Okay. And here's again with some creative zoning. Yeah, let's speed this up so that it can actually make some progress here. And there we go, there's the situation with the split zone. And it did it again. Unfortunately, there's no way to force it to keep a zone in the size that you make it. Looks like I have an education issue. Probably here. Yep. This should be easily resolved. Okay. Let's see. We've got another one in here. Need to see the zone view here to see what... Nope, we don't. Okay, good. Oh, it did it again. You know what? I'm going to make this one zone high density. Got a power issue. Where's the power plant? Oh, right. I put the power plants over here. Ah, it's starting to get old. Okay. So what I'm going to do, because I only have the one power plant, I'm going to pause it so I can demolish it and rebuild it. Okay, so... hydrogen power. Gotta wait for the smoke to go away. Okay. Replace the power plant. And now we're only at 74%, so it should be good now. But while it's paused, I'm gonna go up here and I'm going to replace these as well. An interesting little fact is as water pumps and power plants and so on age, the maintenance costs go up over time. So you can actually save money in your budget by replacing your big infrastructure like that before it gets obsolete. Now, I need to finish my I need grass there. And I need it here as well. Okay, so now I'll just bring this grass area all the way down here. Okay, now I put in my trees. And I'm going to continue this across here as well. And there we go, it went and did it again. There we go. We'll see if that behaves this time. There we go. Okay. Good. Now, apparently commute time is too long. Okay. Slow this back down. Now, it's complaining about the landfills being, well, teeming. And there you go, they are getting fairly full. So, what I'm going to do is add some more landfill. There. Now, in case you're wondering, I built this road here just to make sure that I keep these two pieces separated. Sometimes when you link up existing landfill zones, you get some glitchy behavior. So by doing that, I avoid some of the worst glitchiness. Or at the very least, I avoid doing it accidentally myself. What I'm doing here is getting rid of some of the abandoned industrial buildings. There's really no point keeping the abandoned buildings around. And this also has a side effect of opening up space for other industries if they should decide to come in here, which they probably won't. But either way, it looks better at least. What do we got in here? Okay, so that's fine. Okay, so what I'm going to do here, I'm going to add a passenger rail station or two, since we have the rail here. So, rail, passenger station. So we'll put one here, and we'll put one here. And make sure that it has a road connection. Now, Oh, there you go. There's some actual usage there. And I think I need one over here as well. Okay. Actually, I need to. How do I get this in here? I think that's the only way. Okay. Good. And I think one more here. Right, okay. I think eventually there'll be one over here as well. Okay. Let's see. Okay, good, good, good. What I really need is some public transportation in the rest of the city, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to work on filling the rest of this in, and then once I've done that, I'll start retrofitting in things like subway system, make it as though the city grew with no public transportation and then expanded it, which really isn't quite so far-fetched as it might sound. Even these days, quite a lot of development occurs without any real thoughts toward the future. Let's see about demand here. Yeah, still lots of industrial demand, but I think I need some services over here, particularly fire. Police. Okay. Now, I'm going to add some roads here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I'll do that. And like so. That can go across. That can't. Okay. No. Yeah. Bring a road there. Yeah, I'll make a connection there. And no connection there. Bring a road across this way. Okay. No. Right. No. Quite in the right place. Oh, I should save this before I crash the game. Yeah, that would be good. Don't crash the game. Okay. Now I need to relink that. I think I just put that in the same wrong place. See, okay. Right. Okay, this should help with jobs, simply because it's closer to the development I just built. This area should be reasonably attractive for the industry because it has very short freight trips to the city boundary. Now, let's see. What's the situation here? Okay, good. Okay, I'm going to have this road connect up that way, and this one will connect this way, but I'm not sure how the rest will connect up. This area here, I believe, will continue to be industrial. On this side, I'm not sure. Okay, let's take a look in here. The high-tech industrial is still high. Okay, so should be okay. I think next time around I'm going to have to start looking at some sort of public transit, maybe buses. Maybe subway for longer haul. Either that, or I'm going to have to start looking at other highway crossings. Although, yeah, I'll have to think about that. Anyway, that's more development here for you. So I'm going to restore the simulation here. Just check the news report here. Yeah, it looks good. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to call it a part here. Basically, next time around, I'll probably continue working on that southeast corner. I'm not completely sure on that, but we'll see. And without further ado, I'll call that a part. See you next time. Thank you for watching.